With all of the problematic and buggy updates that Microsoft has been releasing to Windows 11 lately, I thought it'd be a good idea to show you how you can uninstall updates and how you can clear your update cache to prevent those updates from reinstalling again automatically. But before we get started, this video is sponsored by KeysFan. If you've got an unactivated copy of Windows or Office, then you should check out KeysFan. They offer Windows 10 and 11 and Microsoft Office product keys at discounted prices. To get started, check out the special links in the description box below and then select whatever product you need. I'm going to use Windows 11 Pro as an example. On the checkout page, make sure to use my special coupon code MEMORY50 to get 50% off all Windows licenses and MEMORY62 to get 62% off all Office licenses. After that, you'll be able to select your preferred payment method like PayPal or a credit card and then proceed with the order. Now KeysFan will send you the license key along with instructions on how to activate your product. To activate Windows, just navigate to the activation page in Windows Settings, click on Change Product Key, and then enter the product key to activate Windows with a legal license. Trust me, if you've been running an unactivated copy of Windows or you've been stuck on a home edition and you want to upgrade it to Pro, now is the perfect time to do so using my coupon codes with the links in the description box down below. Thanks to KeysFan for sponsoring this video. Now right here, I'm on the Windows update screen in Windows 11 and currently this operating system is up to date with the latest available Windows updates. So to uninstall an update, I need to come over to the Update History tab here, and if I click on that, it'll show me all of the installed updates, the different types of installed updates, and you can see there are quite a few here. But under the related settings here, I've got this Uninstall Updates tab. So if I click on that, it says that it found two updates that I can uninstall. Now, something that's very important, if you look up here, you'll see that it says you won't be able to uninstall some updates because uninstalling updates may put your PC at risk. Now, this is related to security updates and sometimes also driver updates. So that's why there's a discrepancy between the updates that can be uninstalled that you see here. And if we go back to the update history, all of these different updates that you see here. So for example, we won't be able to uninstall this security update. But if we go to the Uninstall Updates tab again, you can uninstall the feature updates and just other updates that are not security updates. So to uninstall an update, you can just click on the Uninstall button here on the right. And if I click on that, you'll get a confirmation. I'm just going to click on Uninstall and then wait for that to finish. And to finish up, a restart is required. But since I have another update that I want to uninstall, I'm just going to restart later. And then also uninstall this update and then click on uninstall once again and then wait for that to finish. So now that it's finished, we'll also need to restart so it can finish uninstalling the update. So I'm going to go ahead and click on restart now to do that. And then once the computer is restarted, we'll also clear the update cache by deleting the software distribution folder, which contains the files for the updates to install. And we're going to do that so that the updates don't automatically reinstall again after we've just uninstalled them. Okay, so the computer has just restarted. And if I navigate back to settings and then Windows Update, and we have a look at the update history once again, and then go to Uninstall Updates, you'll see there are no updates found that can still be uninstalled. So the next thing we need to do is we need to open the File Explorer, then go to this PC, and then I'm going to navigate to local disk C and then Windows. And then inside of this folder, there's going to be a folder called Software Distribution, which is this folder here. Now, this Software Distribution folder is where all of the updates are downloaded to. And to delete the update cache, you can just select it. Then if you hold down left shift on your keyboard and then click on the delete icon, it's going to permanently delete the folder, and that's what I want to do because I want to clear the update cache. So I'm going to click on yes. I'll need to provide permission to delete the folder, so I'm just going to click on continue. Now, as you can see here, it says the action can't be completed because the file is open in Windows Update. So in this case, what we'll need to do is click on the search icon and then type services so we can open the services panel. And then in the services panel here, we need to go all the way down to W so we can find the Windows Update service, which is this one. And you can also see that it's running at the moment. So I'm just going to right click on the Windows Update service and then stop it. And now that it's stopped, we can try and delete the file again. And if we now go into the software distribution folder, you'll see it only has logs and it doesn't have the actual Windows update files anymore. Last thing that you can do is if you want to prevent updates from being installed, you can go back to Windows Update and then you can pause the updates. And by default, you can pause this for up to 4 weeks so that the updates won't be installed automatically. Windows won't check for or install any updates automatically. But once it gets to the expiry date of when the Windows updates were paused, then it's going to automatically download and install all of the available updates once again. If just pausing the updates is not enough for you and you actually want to disable the updates as well, then you can do that through my tool called Winhance, which is the Windows Enhancement Utility. In Winhance, on the Optimizations tab, Windows Update Settings, where you'll have a Windows Update policy, and you can see that currently Winhance has detected that the Windows updates are paused for a long time, but you also have the option of disabling it. Now, this is not recommended, but for some reason, if you needed to disable the Windows updates completely, this is the way that you can do it. Now that it's finished, if we now navigate to the Windows settings and to Windows Update, it's just not going to work as expected, because the Windows update is completely disabled. But once again, this is not recommended to be used for an extended period of time, but it does exist for you if you need it. If you've never heard of or used Winhance before, I'm gonna link a video at the end of this screen that you can check out to get more information about it. But I really hope this video was useful to you. If it was, please give the video a like and consider subscribing to the channel. And as always, I just wanna give a special shout out to all of my YouTube members. Thanks so much for your support. I really appreciate it, and I'll talk to all of you guys soon.